This video is brought to you by my supporters on Patreon, Buy Me a Coffee, and YouTube. If you'd like to support me, you can find the links below. I still remember the first time I made a video on Sadhguru and his confidence when he talks about his pseudoscientific ideas. It was nearly 3 years ago. I had like less than 300 subs back then. I've grown a little since, making videos on a ton of topics around people that peddle pseudoscience. But I thought it's time to look back at the man who has single-handedly brought down the IQ of the entire nation, and this time to use him to learn some critical thinking skills. In fact, let's make this a series on the channel, Critical Thinking 101, where we look at videos and discuss how we should actually interpret them, starting with the man himself, Sadhguru aka Jaggi Vasudev. Now, before I begin, I thought I should justify why I said he single-handedly did this to YouTube India. 3 years ago was a time when someone like Beer Biceps was an innocent little boy making science-based fitness content copying Western influences. The only major source of pseudoscience on YouTube India was this man.
If I take a glass of water in my hand and just look at it in a certain way and give it to you, well-being will come to you.
And I'm pretty sure he was the inspiration for all the creators that came onto this niche, peddling all this pseudoscience and making a fool out of their own audiences. He was the one who showed them the way. And judging by how much pseudoscience content there is on YouTube, I'll probably never run out of content to make at this rate. If I were to make that video today, what would I change? Probably nothing about the content of the video, but what I would change is the tone in which I said everything. Because the tone of the video certainly made it very unwelcoming to someone who disagreed with me, people who were already fans of Sadhguru. Because of my tone, probably my criticisms were invalid in their minds. I'll make sure that doesn't happen with this video. Let's look at some of the claims he makes and let's think about them critically, starting with them.
On a certain day, I just, in a field hockey game, I fractured my left ankle and I went and sat down in a place. I was in excruciating pain, and by then I had also become a chronic asthmatic and I had a very severe bout of asthma. I sat down with my eyes closed for about little more than an hour. When I came out, my asthma left me, never to come back again. And above all, my fractured leg was perfectly okay in little more than an hour's time.
There are so many problems with this clip that I don't know where to begin. He says that he mended a fractured leg by closing his eyes and sitting with a certain resolve for an hour. This claim seems so impossible in comparison with everything we know about bones and fractures and how they heal. But let's keep our minds open and see what evidence he provides. Oh, that's right, he provides no evidence. He wants us to take his word for it. Now, to someone who is a fan of this person, I have to ask, and I'm sure there are many watching this right now, please tell me, what is the difference between what he is saying and a blatant lie? Please let me know in the comments. I'm pretty sure someone is halfway through typing a comment that says, "You idiot, he didn't have a camera with him when he had that experience to provide you with evidence." Sure, but he has an entire film crew with him now, doesn't he? In his own words, he has developed systems and technologies that millions of people are using today to achieve results. I'm sure in all that time, he would have been able to capture the mending of a bone without medical intervention, or the curing of an incurable disease, and display it on that big screen for everyone to see. Wouldn't that make it easier for all of us to believe? The unfortunate thing is that he makes claims like this all the time. But the people who follow him see him as a person of such virtue that he couldn't possibly lie or be mistaken. They fail to see what he has to gain by making people believe the things he says. He can get millions of people to sign up for his courses or buy his products or donate to his organization. If I were to sum up all that I said in one sentence, extraordinary claims require extraordinary evidence. Next clip.
If I take a glass of water in my hand and just look at it in a certain way and give it to you, well-being will come to you. If I look at it another way and give it to you, you will fall sick tonight. This is no more superstition, this is science.
I have this clip in my original Sadhguru video, but I didn't go into detail over there, so let's do it over here. When you hear water memory claims, you mainly hear about the works of these three scientists: Jaques, Benveniste, Masaru, Emoto, and Luc Montagnier. I've gone into more detail into what they actually did, links in the description. All three either had their papers retracted or the study never passed peer review. Let's think about this critically. The claim that water has memory and can remember what was dissolved in it seems impossible when you compare it with everything we know about how water behaves. So before you believe it, you want to make sure that this couldn't possibly be wrong or be some mistake. You want to make sure that the study that found this or concluded this actually got it right and didn't make some stupid error. That's why you need a peer review process in place. And if a study doesn't pass it, it shouldn't be counted as evidence. Water has memory is an extraordinary claim with terrible evidence. If you don't have extraordinary evidence to back your extraordinary claim, don't expect people to believe it. Next claim.
If a woman delivers a male child, the quality of the milk that she produces is in a certain way. If she delivers a female child, the quality of the milk is totally different. If she delivers twins, one male and one female, one breast will ooze certain type of milk, another breast will ooze another kind of milk.
Again, no evidence for the extraordinary claim he's making. I think he may have misread the results of this study and made his own conclusion that confirms his own bias. The study talks about different compositions of milk for a male and a female child, but says nothing about twins. Here's how you think about this, even if you had no study. How does the mother know which side is for the male child and which side for the female? What if she feeds a male child on the wrong side? If a kind of physiology like this were there in the body, does that make it intelligent or stupid? Whenever you hear an extraordinary idea like this with no evidence, try to think of counter ideas or counter examples that wouldn't make any sense if this were true. Next claim. Now, this is a video conference in Russia featuring Michio Kaku, an established physicist. We'll get to claims in the video, but here's the thing that spiritual gurus do often. They might go to scientific conferences or scientific institutes often, and after their talk, their fans will go around saying, "Hey, Sadhguru had a talk with Michio Kaku," as though somehow it gives more validity to his words. He might have had conversations with scientists, but the content of what he says stands on its own merit. Let's look at the video.
Right now, there is more memory in every DNA that you carry or every cell in your body than your entire brain can carry. Because you may not remember how 10 generations ago your great-great-great-grandfather looked like, but his nose is sitting on your face right now.
What Sadhguru often does is he hijacks words and uses them in a different context. Like for example, here he's using the word memory. He says evolutionary memory when he should simply be using the word information. The DNA within each cell contains information on what it should do. It doesn't remember what to do, it decodes information in the DNA and performs appropriate functions in the body so as to contribute to the organism's survival. The problem with using the word memory in its place is this. There is an established meaning for the word memory, and people will often confuse what Sadhguru is saying when he uses the word memory with the way the word is actually supposed to be used. That is, people remembering things. Like, for example, the host is about to confuse it in this clip.
How can we resolve this issue? Because technological improvements are not improving human beings. Maybe because the memory, ancestral memory, is so strong in us that we still remember how our ancestors were fighting over a piece of bread. Maybe we'll continue doing the same because of the memory we have.
Notice how she's actually confused and is using the word memory in a completely different manner. Ancestral memory about fighting over a piece of bread, there's no way anyone can remember it. There's no way DNA can have information regarding it. This is definitely not an honest mistake that Sadhguru is making, because if you watch his other videos, he's trying to sell you the idea that the body is intelligent, it has memory, etc., that you can improve by doing his course.
This intelligence and this competence within the human system.
The intelligence of the body is such.
He does this with many other terms also, like technology, engineering, etc.
And I went about creating systems that people could make use of today, these technologies for inner well-being, these methods to engineer your interiority the way you want it.
This kind of reminds me of Jordan Peterson and how he does this with the term God.
Well, God is what you use to make sense of your life, by definition. You have a hierarchy of values. You have to, otherwise you can't act or you're painfully confused. Whatever is at the top of that hierarchy of values serves the function of God for you.
When the average person who has his own understanding of the word God watches this, they'll just confirm their own beliefs without caring about what Jordan Peterson means when he says God. Since we're on the topic, I think Jordan Peterson is the Sadhguru of the West, or Sadhguru is the Jordan Peterson of the East, depending on how you look at it. Maybe I'll make a video on that topic soon. But whenever someone makes use of a word or a term in two different meanings, two different ways, they're committing an equivocation fallacy. I talked about this in my video on how Zakir Naik tries to deny evolution by committing an equivocation fallacy on the word theory.
There is no book so far that I've read which talks about fact of evolution. Theory of evolution means the theory.
The link to that video is in the description. Now, this kind of pseudoscience from Sadhguru is never ending, so I'll be making more videos on him. But that creates a problem for me. Now, here's the thing. I need money to survive. And I do YouTube full time. I have no other sources of income. Of course, I've merch and all that, but ultimately, they're all dependent on YouTube. And fun fact, they hardly help. I tried going for sponsors, they do pay decent money, but here's the problem with that. They don't want to support videos like these on criticizing Sadhguru or any other YouTuber or any religious themed video, etc. And you'll notice that recently I've been trying making more brand friendly content. I stopped doing risky stuff, so I might get sponsors. But you know what happened? The channel views came down because the audience clearly doesn't like topics like these. So I've decided to go back to doing these kinds of riskier videos, fighting pseudoscience and whatnot. And I love making these kinds of videos, but you know who doesn't? The sponsors. So there goes that source of income, and YouTube ad revenue is shit. So I'm left with one option, and that is to ask you for support. And I'm sure a lot of you would love to support me. You love my videos. So let's discuss how you can support me. My most preferred option is Patreon and Buy Me Coffee, because more than 90% of this money goes to me and the platforms take a very small cut. I also have a UPI ID, which I've linked down below, where 100% of the money goes to me, but your support there will be private and anonymous. Patreon is long-term support for me, and in return, I give you a lot of rewards. But if you want to do a one-time support, I prefer Buy Me a Coffee. There you can also send me a message along with your support. And the best part about Buy Me a Coffee, you don't even have to sign up to support a creator. I also have merch and a website where you can support me, as well as YouTube memberships and that thanks button as a last option. But most importantly, I want to say, support me only if you can afford it. If you can't, then I'd appreciate if you share this video so it reaches more people. If you want to watch that original Sadhguru video I made, check it out over here. I'll see you in the next one. Till then, remember, science is dope.